All right, I kind of wanted to cover this story for an entire segment because I think it's a lot bigger than what people are not realizing, because it's really not getting out there that much. But here's the story. Here's the headline. Market Watch, Wall Street Journal. Your right to resell your own stuff is in peril. Now, this might be laughed off or shrugged off, or, well, who's going to be winning the college football games this weekend or whatever, but you need to understand the importance of this. We talk a lot about the economy. We talk a lot about business. We obviously have two presidential candidates who were on the debate stage earlier this week pretending to address the economy. But I'm going to read this to you. And while I do, think. Just think. Here we go. Chicago, Market Watch, Wall Street Journal. Tucked into the U.S. Supreme Court's busy agenda this fall is a little-known case that could upend your ability to resell everything from your grandmother's antique furniture to your iPhone 4. An issue known as Kurtzeg versus John Whitley and Sons is the first sale doctrine in copyright law, which allows you to buy and then sell things like electronics, books, artwork, furniture, CDs, DVDs, anything essentially, without getting permission from the copyright holder of those products. Under the doctrine, the Supreme Court has recognized since 1908, you can resell your own stuff without worry because the copyright holder only had control over the first sale. Put simply, though Apple has the copyright on the iPhone and Mark Owen does on the book No Easy Day, you can still sell your copies to whomever you please, whenever you want, without retribution. That is being challenged now. For products that are made abroad, and if the Supreme Court upholds the appellate court ruling, it would mean that the copyright holders of anything you own that has been made in China, Japan, Europe, for example, would have to be given permission to you before you sell it. That's huge. So all of you people who have garage sales, flea markets, posts on Craigslist, all of you families who are thinking, well, we need more money because just money's just not cutting it. How about we sell some furniture? We don't need that Chase lounge that we have in the other room. I mean, come on, let's get rid of it. Or how about we get rid of this painting? How about we get rid of this television? How about we get rid of this crib or this toy? Whatever it is. The U.S. Supreme Court right now is trying to decide if you have the right to sell it. And they're using copyright law in order to determine that right. Now, the argument could be made on the holder of the copyright. Well, this is really cool, man. that'd be like saying in my book, Quit Your Job or Die. Okay, you bought a copy. I got paid for it. And when you bought it, the publisher sends me a royalty check. Now it's in your house, and you decide, well, you know, I've read it 17 times, and now it's time to sell it at the garage sale. Do I have the right to say, wait, I want another royalty? So obviously there are people who would be in my position, ignorant people, but still people in my position who might say, well, yes, I do. Absolutely, man. Every time you sell my painting or you sell my furniture, I want another royalty. But what does that actually do to the American economy? What if you don't have the ability to sell stuff? That takes away tens of billions of dollars out of American hands. Now, this might be brushed over. Like I said, it's just some easy sort of simple, oh, well, it's just some sort of obscure case in the Supreme Court. We don't need to really worry about it. But the truth is far from that. You do need to worry about this. I'm not a fearmonger. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, really. I'm not spitting at the microphone and yelling all the time. But this is a huge story. This falls in line with stories that we've been seeing come out of communities. Well, the city council has said that you can only have 2 garage sales a year. If you have more than that, then we're going to consider you a business and you need to get permits and retail license and inspection by the state. I know these things seem little. And I know they seem like things that you really don't want to worry about. And, well, Josh, how does this fit into the whole scale of QE3 and all these other huge economic issues? Well, look at it this way. QE3 was a decision made by people outside of your sphere of influence. The government and the Federal Reserve, which is not part of the government, but those entities decided, okay, we're going to do this. Matter of fact, it appears more and more that the Federal Reserve just said they're going to. But that's outside of your control. Is it bad? Yes. Is it devastating to your children's children's children? Yes. But it was outside of your control. This takes away economic viability away from your hands. This actually impacts your ability to make a decision on an economic issue. Can you sell your dresser at a garage sale? Can you auction off stuff? What is this going to do to the auction industry? What is this going to do to an estate auction? There is no way you could hunt down the copyright holders for 500 pieces of furniture, items, tools, toys, art. So if this passes, you can't sell them. If you turn it over and it says made in Germany, you turn it over, it says made in China, hello. You turn it over, it says made in Taiwan, whatever. If this passes, you can't sell it. And while things like QE3 do have economic impact, it's not as direct. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I don't know. I mean, it's one of those issues that we're going to have to watch. We'll keep an eye on it for you. I think it's something that you should be talking about with other people. Now that it's in the Supreme Court, we're not talking about legislation. There's no call your senator and tell them no. No, this isn't that sort of situation. Now we sit back and see what the court decides, and that's what you're given. And as easy as it would be for me to say, yeah, you know what, that's really cool. If I can get a royalty every time somebody sells it or resells it or resells it, sells it. But it just doesn't make any sense. It takes the power away from you. And I think that's what is being overshadowed here. They're talking about it from a copyright issue, and I understand that, and there's some legality there. Believe me, I know. You should see a contract when you write a book. But I'm more concerned about the lack of economic power it gives you. I mean, there goes resale shops, all clothing, all jewelry, antique dealers out of business. I mean, we're probably not even talking about $4 or $5 billion. We're probably talking about $30-40 billion a year that'd be taken out of your hands. When QE3 happens, it goes from banker to banker to banker to banker. And I explained in an earlier segment, I think about 2 months ago, about how when we have economic stimulus now, trickle up doesn't work and trickle down doesn't work. And the reason those two things don't work is because of an entity called debt. It doesn't matter if you trickle it down and count on it going back up, debt's going to eat it in the process. If you start at the top and go down, debt's going to eat it in the process. So both of those things don't work. What still worked was your ability to create some form of income. And for a lot of people, reselling items is their income, at least supplemental. And when that goes away, your power goes away. Back right after this.